domination for Arsenal today, man. Absolute domination. And we needed this. I was saying before the game, it's not just the result we need, it's the performance. And we got both. We got both today, played really, really well. There were phases of the game where we weren't that impressive and I was getting frustrated. I think we started off the first half really, really well, real good intensity, and we didn't let Forest get into any rhythm of their game plan at all. Clearly, they wanted to drop deep, they wanted to frustrate us, and we scored so early after about 4 minutes, I think it was, their game plan was dead. And after getting that start, I thought to myself, it's exactly what Arsenal needed. Because we haven't been on good form recently. In our last five games, we've struggled to, we haven't scored more than one goal in each of our last five games. So I was thinking today, the last thing that I want is for Arsenal to struggle to score. That'd kind of ruin our confidence a little bit, and it would only increase Forest's confidence in terms of their game plan, which is obvious. We knew what they were going to try and do. Thankfully, we managed to get that nice early goal. And I just thought, you know what? It should be sort of plain sailing from here for Arsenal. But we got sloppier and sloppier as that first half went on. And Forest, you know, all they wanted to do, they wouldn't have panicked at 1-0 down, because they can still think they can get something from the game if they just take it into the last 15 minutes where they only need one goal. That's just one moment of brilliance, one mistake. And talking about that one mistake, this game could have been very, very different if the one massive mistake from an Arsenal player in this game cost us. And that is Gabriel running up to the end of the first half. We could have gone in one all at half time, because his brain dead pass, rolling the ball into the 6 yard box. I don't know what he was thinking. But you know what? He's done that too many times this season, where he's made silly mistakes and it's just cost Arsenal. Don't get me wrong, I think he's a very good defender. I do like him, but he needs to cut that sort of stuff out of his game. As far as I'm concerned, Gabriel owes Ben White a sunbed and a new tattoo, because it was Ben White that got that block that saved us. And of all people, if there was one person we didn't want to score a goal against us today, it was that eternal teenager, Jesse Lingard. And who does that stupid Gabriel pass go straight to? Lingard. So Ben White, thank you for that block. Thank you for saving that. Not only did it mean the game didn't take like a different direction and we're back to square one, also Jesse Lingard doesn't act like an absolute muppet on this pitch and gets a gift of a goal. Now, when it comes to man of the match, it's a 5-0 win, and you think to yourself, you know, it's going to have to be an attacker. And Reece Nelson has obviously got to be in contention, because he had such a brilliant game. And I have to be honest, for me, when I see Reece Nelson coming on, I think to myself, why is it not Marquinhos? Because man of the match today?
Yeah. Who do you reckon? Man of the match.
Saliba or Reece
Saliba?
Nelson?
Reece Nelson for
Yeah,
me. Yeah.
Reece Nelson, there we go. Take care, man. Yeah, for me. So talking about Reece Nelson, I look at him and I think to myself, why is it not Marquinhos? Because we know what Reece Nelson is all about. He's had plenty of opportunity at Arsenal, and he hasn't really ever forced himself into that first team or done the business. And now his son Marquinhos has shown promise, he's shown potential. I've often thought to myself, it should be Marquinhos that's coming on. But today, I'm so happy for Reece Nelson. I'm so happy to be proved wrong, because that's what was going through my mind when he came on. Reece Nelson was phenomenal. And it's amazing what a goal or two can do for your confidence. After he got those two goals, his wing play was out of this world. Nottingham Forest fans must be thinking, my God, how good must the first team be if people like Reece Nelson, who never even played for Arsenal, are that good? Because his wing play was out of this world. His footwork, his like decisiveness on the ball, absolutely brilliant. Even towards the end of the game, tried a cheeky back heel for Jesus. He was on a different level today. So he's a strong contender for the man of the match. But for me, man of the match has still got to be William Saliba. Every single time Forest even had a little sniff, I was never worried. Saliba, with his pace and his power, he was just always making himself the favorite for every single ball. He was brilliant. And it's one thing when Reece Nelson, obviously we got the two goals from him in the start of the second half. After that, I thought he was so good. But it's very easy to play well when it's going really, really well for the team. Saliba navigated that difficult period for Arsenal in the first half so well. He was a standout player for me. And if it wasn't for him, if there were a few jitters caused by him, like, for example, Gabriel caused us, I think it could have been a lot more difficult. First half as well, Thomas Partey, I thought he was poor. He was giving the ball away too much, some really sloppy passes. And Ødegaard as well, he didn't put a stamp on the game. He didn't do what we need him to do. Second half, both of those players, their level went up dramatically. Both their players' level went up dramatically. And they led us to that brilliant second half performance. Arsenal in the second half were just brilliant. And this is our best win this season. And as I said earlier, it's the first time in 5 games we've managed to score more than one. So it was so needed. And I was asking after the PSV game, look, is it now time to be concerned about our form? And I was concerned about our form. Thankfully, I know it's Nottingham Forest. I know, yep, they've been the worst team in the Premier League this season. But ultimately, you can only play what's in front of you. And any other team that's played Nottingham Forest this season, they haven't gone and turned them over 5-0. Even Forest, they got a brilliant result against Liverpool recently. So they would have been on the high. Arsenal would have been on the low. And what big teams do when they suffer a defeat, when they don't do well, like away at PSV, they come back with a performance. And that is what Arsenal did today. So this team deserves the praise. At the start of the game, I was talking about how it should be Tierney rather than Tomiyasu. Tomiyasu's done nothing wrong. But at home, to Forest, bottom of the table team, they're struggling for goals, struggling for points on the road. I thought it should be Kieran Tierney. You can afford to play a fullback who's a bit more attacking. But obviously Arteta didn't go for that. And I think that still remains a question for me, because just because we beat Forest comprehensively today doesn't mean that that's the right decision. For me, I feel like Kieran Tierney is going to be feeling quite aggrieved, and he's done nothing wrong not to play. I don't think that it's an issue between player and manager. I just feel like Arteta's been a little bit more pragmatic in his selection, putting Xhaka on the left and not really asking Tomiyasu to do too much going forward. But I want to see Kieran Tierney play. So look, the two things I want to hear from you guys in the comments. What do you think about Tierney versus Tomiyasu in terms of away at Chelsea, for example, who should play left back? Maybe in that game it needs to be Tomiyasu. Maybe we need to respect the opposition a little bit more. But let me know your thoughts. And also, who was your man of the match today? For me, it's Saliba just over Reece Nelson. But let me know, ultimately, you don't opt for a defender very often when you've gone and won 5-0. Thomas Partey's goal in the second half, sensational. Reminded me of his goal against Tottenham. And Ødegaard as well, brilliant. The one thing for me in this game is obviously Saka getting injured. That is a massive headache. Just when he was hitting proper form, just annoying to lose him at that time. And Gabriel Jesus, I was desperate for him to score. He should have scored a goal today. Are you worried about him in front of goal? I feel like, I'll mention it in my 5 at 5 tomorrow, so make sure you catch that. There was one moment in the game that I want all of you to watch back that for me sums up the problem with Jesus' current role in the team. But watch out for my 5 at 5 tomorrow for that. Arsenal are top of the league. Enjoy your day. Hopefully we get a good result in Man United versus West Ham as well. And a lot of the other teams around us lost their games this weekend, Chelsea and Liverpool. And that's important for us. It's going well for Arsenal right now, but we could hit rocky form. So it's important for us to increase that gap between those teams that are definitely going to be in with a chance of top 4. Up the Arsenal, top of the league. See you tomorrow for the 5 at 5.